you know, it's very difficult for me to see anybody even comparing any player to Viv Richards. Viv Richards doesn't come into any of these lists.
Yeah.
And I'm sure young kids who are watching or somebody who hasn't seen Viv Richards must be wondering, what is he talking about? But if you'd seen Viv Richards' bat, which we were blessed to have seen, he doesn't come into any of these lists. But it doesn't mean that there is a better player than Viv Richards that's been
around. He is top of every list for me.
More dominating than him, more consistent than him, you know, did it when it mattered. So sometimes numbers don't tell you a story.
All of you, for those who've not seen Viv Richards' bat, go to YouTube and just watch the highlights. And keep one thing in mind, like a lot of the innings that he played in Australia, much bigger grounds.
Yeah.
Right? That those bats were not the bats that they are now. Right?
Yeah.
Those were not. So just multiply all those things in your head when you see the ability.
And just add one more thing. There was no field restriction in those days.
Correct.
You could have 9 fielders on the boundary if you wanted. And there was no 30-yard circle. The ball didn't change. So there is, it's a different era. I think we've got to enjoy Virat Kohli, and we are just blessed that we have him on our side.
Just for a second on Viv Richards, at that time, playing in that era, average of 47, a strike rate of 90 in ODIs.
Yeah.
A strike rate of 90. You know how they say, oh, this was worth 1 lakh in 1950 and is worth 10 lakhs today?
Yes.
A 90 strike rate in the late 80s is a 150 strike rate today.
Yeah.